All students, I hope you are doing fine. I am Professor Masood Fuzail. Today we are going to discuss life cycle of Obelia. Obelia is a small colonial animal which belongs to phylum Coelenterata or phylum Cnidaria. They are colonial organism present in the oceans, marine water only. They are attached with a substratum with help of a disc-like structure which is also known as holdfast. After attachment, they have a animal-like body which is colonial in shape, and it has different zooids in this colony. The first zooid, as you can see here, is known as gastrozooid. Gastrozooid is animal-like structure in this colonial organism which is responsible for feeding of the colony. It has tentacles on its top which are involved in the prey. The second zooid is known as gonozooid. Gonozooids are responsible for asexual reproduction by budding. Both gonozooid and gastrozooids are present in the same colony. This colony may be 1 cm to several centimeters long. During reproduction, gonozooid, which is a zooid present in this colony, reproduces asexually, a process known as budding. During budding process, small outgrowths, buds, are produced on the surface of the gonozooid, which are released into the water with the help of a small pore present on the surface of the gonozooid. These buds, when come out into the water, they develop flagella like structure and become a other body form which is known as medusa. There are two types of medusa, male medusa and female medusa. They are very small, about 1 millimeter in diameter and in size. They grow, feed in water, and they develop gonads. Female medusa produces eggs in his gonads, while male medusa produces sperms in his gonads. Male gonads, gametes and female gametes, eggs and sperms are released in the water where fertilization takes place. After fertilization, zygote is formed. Soon this zygote changes into a structure known as blastula. Blastula later on develops cilia on its surface and become a larva known as planula larva. This is free swimming larva known as planula. Planula larva swim in the water, feeds on microorganisms, and after growing at some point, it attaches with some substratum and develops into a new polyform of the Obelia. And this Obelia starts to develop into a new colony. So in this way, there is alternation of generation in this animal. This animal give rise, the polyform give rise to medusa, and medusa give rise to polyform. So this is a phenomena which is known as alternation of generation, which is found in animal kingdom. Both of these generation, polyform and medusa form, are haploid, but polyform reproduces asexually by budding, while medusa reproduce sexually with the help of gametes into polyform. So in this way, these two generations give rise to each other. Polyform give rise to medusa, medusa give rise to polyform. There is another phenomena which is also found in Obelia, which is a colonial coelenterate, that is known as polymorphism. Poly mean many, morph mean form, cis mean condition. It is a condition where occurrence of structurally and functionally more than two different types of individuals called zooids in the same organism. In this condition, there are two different types of organism which are animal-like zooids. They are present in the same organism. So this is an organism which is an Obelia. It is a colonial coelenterate. It has two types of organisms. Number one, gastrozooids. Gastrozooids are animal-like zooids which are capable of feeding. They have tentacles on their top surface, and they are involved in taking prey in the water and feeding the whole colony. The other zooid is known as gonozooid. Gonozooids are specialized in budding process, which is a method of asexual reproduction. And there is another body form of medusa, which is known, zooids which are known as medusa. Medusa are free swimming, umbrella like, and they reproduce sexually. So in this way, in the same organism, there are more than two different body forms of animals which are found, and this phenomena is known as polymorphism. So best example of polymorphism is Obelia. The other examples are Physalia, which is a colonial cylindrate which lives in water. It is also known as man of war. So in this way, today we have just discussed life cycle and reproduction in Obelia, which is a colonial cylindrate in animal kingdom. I hope it you have understood it. If you do, please like it, subscribe it, share with your friends. See you in the next lecture. Bye.